Good morning, students. Good morning. Today we are going to discuss about first unit revision topic. Okay. So my voice is audible, students. So only 17 people are students till now. Good morning, students. And today we discussed about asymptotic notation. We are going to discuss about asymptotic notation. So what is an asymptotic notation? So actually, what is asymptotic Vigo notation means? Here, Vigo notation allows its users to simplify function in order to concentrate on their growth rates. I differentiate function with the same growth. Okay, so here asymptotic notations are used to find the time complexity of the given algorithms. Okay, so see here, this is Vigo notation. We have a function is there, that is So here big O notation, see here we have three types of notation, big O notation, omega notation, theta notation. So a given function f of n and g of n, we say that f of n is big O of g of n if there exists a positive constant, that is c and n naught, such that f of n less than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. So here n greater than or equal to n and c is, and c and n naught are constants here. Okay, we are considering one example, f of n equal to 2n plus 10. So how we calculate this function? See here, 2n plus less than or equal to, I am considering c of n. Okay, and then of n greater than or equal to c here, I am calculating this here, and I've taken this side and common n, and I get the value n by c, c of n into c minus 2. Then I took here the n greater than 10 by c minus 2. So here c equal to 3 and n not equal to 10. Then this is one function, and what is c of into c of gn value is, that is c equal to 3 and n not equal to 10. Then the function f of n is less than or equal to g of n. Okay, so g of n value is 3n. Okay, clear students? How we calculated? Okay, so this is big O notation. See another example, I am considering n square as my f of n function. So I am taking c less than or equal to c of n, then n less than or equal to c. So here this is the condition. So here c must be constant here. So here c is not constant, so we cannot consider this example. So these are some of the examples, 7n minus 2, f of n, consider here 3n minus 2. So if 7n minus 2 is greater than or equal to f of n greater than less than or equal to c of n, means that CR 7 minus 2 C dot n. What is the value of CR? C is 7 and n naught is greater than or equal to 1, then only we can call this function. That is f of n less than or equal to C of n. Okay, clear students? Just see the example, you can understand clearly. So here n power is 1, so you consider only Cn, then we have to identify the 7 value. When n equal to 0, this condition will not satisfy. That's why n naught greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so n naught is greater than or equal to 1. C also greater than 1. Okay. So C equal to 7. So 7 into 1, 7. 7 minus 2, 2. So this function is greater than this one. So the condition, so this is the big O notation. Next, see here. Here the highest power is n cube. So I am considering here n cube. Okay. So by taking one by one values, then you get the condition is this one is less than the this one. By when this one is greater than 4, when C equal to 4 and n value is greater than 21. Then the n value or n naught value equal to 21 only, then we get this value f of n is less than or equal to C into g of n. Okay, clear students, or any doubt? I'm just repeating the topic. So far clear? Anyone write a message dot box? Then see here, the highest power is log n. So in this highest power is log n, so we are considering C into log n. Whenever the C value is 8 and n not equal to 2, then this function will satisfy f of n less than or equal to C into g of n. When the C value is 8 and n not equal to 2. Clear, students? See here, big O growth rate. So big O notation gives already upper bound on the growth of the rate. So the statement f of n is big O of 0 means that the growth rate of f of n is no more than the growth rate of g of n. So here g of n grows more, f of n is g of n is s, and it grows more, the g of n is big O of no. Okay, here f of n grows more, here g of n is less, is no, and f of n is here s. Same growth, both are s. Okay, so what are the rules for big O notation? So if f of a is a polynomial of degree d, then f of n is big O of n power d. I already told you the highest power we are considering here. So drop lower order terms and drop constant factor. Use the possible class of functions. So here 2 of n is big O of n. We are going to 2 of n is instead of. So we just consider the related values only, we don't consider the highest powers. So see here, if 2 of n is, I am considering big O of n. If 2 n is big O of n square, it is not considered. You consider only related values. Okay. Close to that value. You are taking the values which is close to that value. here big O, big omega, big theta. Okay. Big O means big O is an SM less than or equal to G of N. Big omega means greater than or equal to F of N is asymptotically greater than or equal to G of N. And big theta is F of N is asymptotically equal to G of N. So example use the here pi n square is omega of n square. Here if F of N is big O of is omega of G of N, if there exists a constant C greater than 0 and integer constant N0 greater than or equal to 1. So the highest power is n square, so we are considering n square. So 5 n square equal to 5 n square, or we are considering 5 n. Okay. For theta, we are considering this one, C naught, C equal to 1, N naught equal to 1 here. For omega, C equal to 5 and N naught equal to 1. Okay. So, see, these examples, you can clearly understand what is notations. Okay, and next one is next we move to the next we see okay, next we see the next one is that is students, so I already told you time complexity of the algorithm. So next we move to the performance analysis. So here what is the performance analysis means? So here the number of steps by any program statement is assigned depending upon the kind of statement. For example, see here comments count as 0 steps and assigned statement which does not involve any calls to other arguments is count 0 and is assigned as 1 step. And iterative statements such as for, while and statements depending upon their condition. So see here, in here we are considering while loop. See here, while statement is given a step count equal to number of step counts assigned to expression. Okay, so this step count for each execution of the control part of a statement is 1. So that is expression 2, expression 1. Okay. See here, I already told you for algorithm, it will take 0. For condition, it will take 1 count. For return value also count. And here it will take a loop for n times of 1 plus 1 and brackets 0. Okay. Here also see here. Frequency here, it indicates m plus 1 times and here m of n plus 1 here, mn times, the loop ends with mn. The total step is 2m plus 2mn plus 2m plus 1. So that is performance analysis, we already discussed in that one. So this is the big O notation. So see here, we already done. So here for the big O is theta is 0. Here also 0. Here installation 1, so big O of 1. Here loop runs from 1 to n. So here big O of n. Actually n plus 1, we are considering highest power, that is n. So big O of n, here also loop repeat n times, so theta of n, and here 1 theta of 1, total complexity is, total steps in it is theta of n. Okay. See student, this graph is very important. So here the least value is log n, then n, then next highest value is n log n, then n square, then highest one is 2 power n. These are the function values. First one, n, first constant value, then log n, then n log n, then n square n. N log n. So already the performance measurement means time complexity and the space complexity called as performance measurement. Okay. Next, we coming to the next one, next topic, that is see here in this, any doubt you have, asymptotic notations, big O and omega notation. See example, if you have any doubt, please write a message in chat box. Just consider the highest power only. Just consider highest power only. Okay, any doubt, students? No, any doubt, just ping my message. See your students. So see the example here. So here, what happens when n grows here? So what happens when n is grows here? So why we are using attempted notation means most algorithms are fast for small n values. So here we have the time difference too small to be noticeable. Okay. Here, but n is often the large practice. So that is databases, internet, graphics. So use n, the randomly the n value is grows here. Okay. Okay. Okay, students, and tomorrow we will discuss about asymptotic notations with some other examples also, and then we move to the MRDIZ analysis. And we also discuss about performance analysis. Okay. And today we end the class, and tomorrow we will discuss the remaining topics. Thank you, students.